To understand GFS and PSDS, it is crucial to know how the complete integrated framework comes together and why elements are grouped the way they are in the framework.
The opening balance sheet values plus economic flows equal the closing balance sheet values. There are two main kinds of economic flows that can change the values of stock positions between two points in time: transactions and other economic flows. We distinguish between two types of other economic flows: holding gains and losses, or revaluations, and other changes in the volume of assets and liabilities. Let us first focus on the most common type of economic flows, transactions. We have defined transactions that increase net worth as revenue, and transactions that decrease net worth as expense. The difference between revenue and expense is the net effect of all transactions on net worth, and this is called the net operating balance. This balancing item is an important indicator of the sustainability of fiscal policies conducted through transactions.
In other words, those things that government or another public sector entity have direct control over.
We then move down the transactions column to transactions in assets and liabilities. We start with the transactions in non-financial assets, which we call the net investment in non-financial assets.
The sum of expense and the net investment in non-financial assets provides us with another important aggregate for fiscal policy making called expenditure.
Note that this aggregate is not exactly the same as the well-known budgetary aggregate called expenditure, because the latter does not take into account disposals of non-financial assets. If we take the difference between revenue and expenditure, or revenue minus expense minus net investment in non-financial assets, we get the bottom line balancing item called net lending, net borrowing. In simple terms, the net lending, net borrowing is the surplus or deficit resulting from all government's operations other than financing. If the net lending, net borrowing balance is positive, we refer to net lending, and if negative, we refer to net borrowing.
When positive, this balancing item is a summary measure indicating the extent to which government is putting financial resources at the disposal of other sectors in the economy or abroad. When negative, this balancing item is a summary measure indicating the extent to which government is utilizing financial resources generated by other sectors in the domestic economy or from abroad.
The net lending, net borrowing balance may thus be viewed as the net financial impact of government operations on the rest of the economy and on the rest of the world. We can also say that net lending, net borrowing shows the impact of government operations on its financial resources or its financial wealth. We then group separately transactions in financial assets and transactions in liabilities. The proper recording of these transactions is crucial for the compilation of public sector debt statistics, because these financing transactions impact the stock of gross and net public sector debt. The result of transactions in financial assets minus transactions in liabilities is called the total net financing, and this equals the total net lending, net borrowing balance. This is because we apply the double entry accounting principle, where every debit entry must have an equal credit entry. Therefore, net lending, net borrowing can be computed as revenue minus expenditure, or as net acquisition of financial assets minus net incurrence of liabilities. In reality, though, it is rarely the case that the financing transactions, which we refer to as below-the-line transactions, equal the net result of the above-the-line transactions in the form of revenue and expenditure. There are plenty of reasons why this would occur. For example, different data sources for above- and below-the-line data, different accounting standards applied to different sets of source data, or the above-the-line data may cover a different set of units than the below-the-line data.
If these differences cannot be resolved, there would be a statistical discrepancy between the above and below the line transactions. A discrepancy would always indicate data quality issues, and its size is an indication of the reliability and the quality of the fiscal indicators.
The next parts of the integrated GFS framework are the opening and closing balance sheets. As you can see, we also distinguish between stock positions in non-financial assets, financial assets, and liabilities. The difference between total assets and liabilities produces the net worth. This is an indicator of the total wealth of a unit. The difference between the stock positions of financial assets and liabilities produces the net financial worth, which is an indicator of the financial wealth of a unit. To complete the integrated framework, we add the two types of other economic flows in assets and liabilities, namely revaluations and other volume changes. The difference between total revaluations in assets and total revaluations in liabilities is the change in the net worth due to revaluations. Similarly, the difference in total other volume changes in assets and total other volume changes in liabilities is the change in net worth due to other volume changes. We can now see that the GFS framework is integrated horizontally as well as vertically.
Everything adds up across or horizontally and vertically for the various types of stock positions and economic flows.